Wouldn't it be amazing if every maiden flight with an RC plane was as smooth as this one right here? Well, with so many different options of airplanes, including things like this EDF electric ducted fan jet, we have real turbine jets like this retrofitted F-22 that I put a turbine in. We got old vintage warplanes that have propellers like this Mustang. We got powered gliders. We got pusher prop planes, and we even have unpowered gliders that are meant to be towed behind an airplane to get in the air. Well, the maiden flight of that little glider you seen in the beginning actually didn't go as well as I made it seem, and that's because of two reasons. First one being it's made out of LWPLA, which is lightweight. Second reason is once he got comfortable flying it, he decided to fly it like it was a stunt plane.
It was a good backyard flyer. No, the wing broke first.
Now, if this was a plane he bought at a store, he would probably be really mad, but because it's 3D printed, he could just print more parts, which is an amazing thing. Now, just as the RC planes you would buy in a store, 3D printed planes come in all different shapes and sizes. They also have things like retractable landing gears, they have flaps, but they do have a lot of differences, and I want to go over some of them with you. Now, stay to the end, and I'll tell you which kind of plane I prefer the most. Now, one of the main differences in 3D printing a plane or just buying a plane in general is going to be the price point. So I'm on FMSHobby.com. FMS is a well-known manufacturer with a lot of options. They usually have deals going. So you see, I can get an EDF for as low as 190 bucks. Now, they don't come with receivers, or this A10 is as high as $650. But the difference is, you know, you're buying a well-engineered machine. Now, Legend Hobby is also an iconic name in the brand. They sell large-scale aircraft. That B-17 is $1,800 for the airframe, and you still need to supply everything else. Now, 3D printed planes are going to be far cheaper. You see that Spitfire for $20 is 6'6". Websites are coming out daily with new planes. We have that 90mm EDF. Next to it's a 50mm EDF. Below in that red and yellow is the Albatross, which we actually printed one of those, and it's an amazing flying airplane. And as you see here, there's 9 pages of options. Now, getting into this isn't gonna be the cheapest thing in the world. Buying a quality printer is expensive. The one that we're running mainly is around $1,300 to $1,400, but there are cheaper options. You could go to Creality and check their Ender series and come in right around $200 to $300 for the printer. Now, you still need to get PLA, which is fairly cheap. The breakdown per cost of a plane is listed in the plane description, but it might only be 30 cents to $2 in filament to print that plane. Now, you're not gonna get quality prints right off the bat. There is a learning curve to this to get to the point of flying planes, but in due time, you will get to the point of your first maiden. Now, this is a 4S plane with a pusher prop. That's why it's so loud. I want you to hear it whiz by. And it's super durable. You don't have to worry about it breaking on tight maneuvers. Now, because it's made out of PLA and it's a pusher prop, we don't have a landing gear. We need to belly land this on grass so we don't scratch the bottom as well as break that propeller. But we do get it down. This right here is the Pond Racer. This was highly anticipated while my good friend Christian was building it. We were super excited, but we were disappointed. It didn't perform the way we were expecting, but that's part of 3D printing planes. There's a big learning curve in setting things up to fly correctly.
Maiden jitters.
I'm hoping I don't. All right, guys, watch out, please. I don't want anybody to get hit.
Really?
They're gone. They just fell off.
Scream, dude.
Is that the PLA vibrating?
Yeah. I think I have an unbalanced spinner. What happened? P38, right?
You better bring it in and fix that spinner. That vibration will break something, huh?
See what happens.
Oh, geez.
Now, we wouldn't have this issue with a factory bought plane, but there's something exhilarating about maidening a plane and being unsure of how it's going to react, trimming it out, and trying to just set it up the best way to fly.
Maybe those battery covers being off is good. Give the ESC some cooling.
Yeah.
We're losing parts.
I dropped the wing.
The verdict.
2 for 2. So this I can fix. No problem. I had a feeling this was going to be an issue because this tail wheel is totally supported by these two hinges.
Now, if this was a store-bought plane, we have two options. We either go on the website and try to find new parts, but if the plane's discontinued, that's a problem, or we glue and fix the current ones. Because it's 3D printed, all we have to do is print what we need and reassemble it.
The Pond Racer, I think you gotta lower your rates and add a little more expo and wait for a calmer day. You might also need to add some AS3X on it.
Honestly, I think I might need a gyro one. That thing is all over the place, dude.
I also want to note that heat does make these planes, so heat will destroy them. That's why we're underneath the tent in the summer, because this plane will melt. Now, while factory planes and 3D printed planes both have a lot of differences, I think that there will always be a market for both, and I'm excited to see how 3D printed evolves. Although I don't think they will get to the point of R&D where they'll be able to make a flight controller like this B2 has to enable this thing to fly super flawlessly like it does. I do think 3D printed planes will always be a thing because people like assembling, people like tinkering, and people like creating their own masterpieces. So whether you're flying 3D printed, you're flying manufactured, you're flying balsa, or you're flying a paper airplane, as long as you're in the air having fun with something that you love, continue to do what you do. Now, if you guys want to see more 3D printed planes on my page, let me know. And as always, thanks for watching.